Hello guys, let's look at the following organic chemistry questions. Please make sure you subscribe to this channel, turn on the notification button so that you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. Now, we are going to take the questions one after the other. To begin, let's take question one. Question one says, which of these alcohols cannot be prepared by the hydrogenation of aldehydes and ketone? Now, one of the things that you need to know is when the aldehydes are hydrogenated, the general formula of the aldehyde is this, which is R and then H, double bond O. When they are hydrogenated, that is addition of hydrogen in the presence of catalysts such as platinum, palladium and what, carbon, it will give a primary alcohol. So this will give us a primary alcohol. Okay, so whenever aldehydes are hydrogenated, primary alcohol are formed. Now how about ketones? Now whenever ketones are hydrogenated, secondary alcohols are formed. So the alcohol that will be formed here is R, C, O, H, and what? R. So these are the two alcohols that will be formed whenever aldehydes or ketones are hydrogenated. It's either it forms a primary alcohol from aldehyde, or what, a secondary alcohol from ketones. Okay, secondary alcohols from ketones. Now if you look at the options, what you should be going or what you should be looking at for is the alcohol that is not a primary alcohol and at the same time it's not secondary. Now this alcohol here, is it primary or secondary? Is it primary alcohol? Now why is it primary? The OH is attached to a carbon that is attached directly to only one carbon. Are we getting it? So this is a primary alcohol. Now this is a secondary alcohol. Why? Because the carbon carrying the OH is attached to how many alkyl group? Is attached to two alkyl groups. So this is secondary. This is what? Primary. Now how about this? What kind of alcohol is this? Now this is also a secondary alcohol. This is also a secondary alcohol, because if you bring this out, it's CH3, then CH, then we have CH, this one is branch CH3, then here you have the what, the OH, which is this group here, is on top of this carbon. Okay, then you have CH3. What kind of alcohol is this? This is secondary alcohol. Okay, now it's secondary alcohol because this alkyl group here, there's an alkyl group here and there's another what, alkyl group there. So here we have two alkyl group. There's one here which runs from here down to this point and there's another one here. So this is secondary. Now however, if you look at this one, this is a tertiary alcohol. Why? If I want to bring it out, I'll bring it out as this CH3, then you have the carbon, you have the OH. This CH3 into place three places means that this carbon here is attached to three CH3. Okay, so we have one CH3, we have another CH3, and we have the final CH3. So in this group we have the carbon carrying the OH attached to C2 and 3 CH3s. Okay, that is RCOH. You have R and you have what, R. Now this kind of alcohol is called tertiary alcohols, and we said that the aldehydes and ketones or ketones can only give either a primary alcohol or what, a secondary alcohol. They don't give tertiary alcohol. So the one that is wrong is this one. This one cannot be prepared by the use of primary alcohol, secondary alcohol. Hence, the correct answer to this question is option D, because we are looking for the one that is what? False. Hence, option D is the correct answer. Now let's look at the next question. The next question says, what will be the product of the reaction between methyl magnesium chloride and ethanol? Supposed to be ethanol, okay? Methyl magnesium chloride and ethanol using diether ether as solvent. This is supposed to be ethanol using diether ether as solvent. Now, what is the methyl magnesium chloride? This is the formula for methyl magnesium chloride: CH3MgCl. This is the methyl magnesium chloride. Okay, it's a Grignard reagent. Okay, methyl magnesium chloride, it's a Grignard reagent. Now we say Grignard reagent, they have the general formula of what? They have the general formula of RO-MgS, where R is an alkyl group, Mg is magnesium, and S is a halogen. In this case, the halogen represented is chlorine. So when Grignard reagent reacts with aldehydes or ketones, they form what? Alcohol, depending whether it's an aldehyde or what? A ketone. So when it reacts with ethanol, what will be formed? We have ethanol as CH3C double bond O H. This is ethanol. Okay, when this ethanol reacts with the Grignard reagent, what will be formed? Now we know that this group here will split because carbon is more electronegative than magnesium. If it splits, what are we going to have? We have the partially negative charge here. I will have a positive charge here. Now this negative charge here is a perfect nucleophile. Okay, now since it's a perfect nucleophile, what will it do? It will attach the base of this carbon, and as it's coming here, the valency of carbon is no longer complete again. Hence, this one will undergo mesmerism, to undergo mesmeric effects. We add this afterward to come up. Okay, so what will this give? This will give CH3C. This one becomes O minus because of this bond that came up. Then we have the CH3 group attached, and then H. Now note that this is positively charged, which is MgBrO plus. The positive for this one we attach here, so we have MgBrO plus. Okay, so this we undergoes acid hydrolysis. It will undergo acid hydrolysis, whereby this H here will come and attach to this OH, and MgBrO we go, and this will now form something like this. Form CH3. Here will be what? OH. Here will be H, and here will be CH3 plus. Okay, let me write the product here. Let's say, let's write the general reaction here. This is CH3, this C, this O minus MgBrO, and this is CH3, this is H. When this undergoes acid hydrolysis plus H2O, this will give us CH3, C, here is OH, here is H, here is CH3 plus. Now when this thing splits, it gives us H plus and what? OH. The OH will now react with this group here to form Mg OH and then what? BrO. So what is this product? This product is called 2-propanol. It is called what? 2-propanol. Why is it 2-propanol? If I want to bring this out in the straight form, what will be our longest continuous chain? The longest continuous chain is this. You have it as CH3 C. This is what? OH. I can decide to take this CH3 up and then take this H down. You see the same thing, okay? Since they are attached to the same carbon. So what will be the name? You can number this one, number one. This is number two, and this is what? Number three. So the name of this compound is what? 2-propanol, which is a secondary alcohol. So whenever aldehydes react with greener reagent, they form what? They form a secondary alcohol, in this case, which is what? 2-propanol. 2-propanol. So that is the product of that reaction. Are we getting it now? That is the product of that reaction. Now, in a shorter way, if you want to easily get your question, your answer to this question, what do you normally do? You know the aldehyde that was given to you. It's a very simple step. Take the aldehyde that were given to you, which is what? CH3, C double bond O, and what? H. This is the aldehyde. Now, what was the Grignard reagent given to you? Methyl magnesium bromide. Break this one down. Take this methyl group, attach it here, change it to OH. You've gotten your answer. This becomes what? CH3C. I told you, attach this CH3 or this group, alkyl group from the bromine or from the Grignard reagent. So this becomes another CH3. Let's use a red pen to indicate that that one came from the bromine group. So we have CH3. And then finally, change this double bond here to what? To OH. It will give you the product of the reaction without going through all this step. So that's the answer to that question. Let's take the next. Now, acid catalyzed hydration of 2-butene, 2-methyl-2-butene yields. Now, hydrolysis follows what is called when you hydrolyze, or when when alkenes are hydrated, that is addition of water, they form alcohol. Now, the major product is according to the Markovnikov rule. The Markovnikov rule states that when hydrogen halides are added to unsymmetrical alkene, the hydrogen goes to the less substituted carbon at the what? Double bond, while the OH from water goes to the more substituted carbon. Are we getting it? Or the carbon with the fewest number of hydrogen. Okay, the hydrogen goes to the carbon with the highest number of hydrogen, that is the less substituted, while the OH goes to the carbon with the fewest number of hydrogen. So what is the structure of 2-methyl-2-butene? First of all, let's write out 2-butene. 2-butene is CH3, CH, double bond, CH, and CH3. Now, 2-methyl-2-butene means, if we want to number this is carbon 1, this is carbon 2, this carbon 3, and this carbon 4. Now, 2-methyl-2-butene means that there is another substituent here, which is at position number what? 3. That's why we call it what? 2-methyl-2-butene. Okay? Now, when this reacts with what? Water. According to the Markovnikov rule, what will be the product form? This is addition reaction. I love to look at it this way. Let's say when water splits, it forms what? H and OH minus. Now, this is not the actual method or the actual mechanism for it, but you can actually use this to always determine your answer. Now, according to the Markovnikov rule, the hydrogen will go to the carbon bearing the highest number of hydrogen, and the OH goes to the carbon bearing the fewest number of hydrogen at the seat of the double bond. Now, here is the seat of the double bond. Now, the double bond, you agree with me that is within these two carbons here, okay? The double bond is within these two carbons. Let's say this, 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 and this. The double bond is within these two carbons, okay? Now, since the double bond is within these two carbons, it means that we are actually looking at these two carbons now. Now, this carbon, which have the highest number of hydrogen, this carbon does not have any hydrogen at all. Why this carbon has one hydrogen? So which one have the highest? Is this number 3. So it means that the hydrogen here will come to this carbon having the highest, and then the OH will go to the carbon having the fewest. So the product of this reaction will be what? To be CH3, then we have C, and then CH3. OH comes to this carbon as carbon number 2, so we add it under as OH. As these two sigma bonds are coming in, the double bond is broken, okay? So here become a single bond. It is broken, and then here becomes CH. Instead of CH now, you know this is normally CH. When this hydrogen add, it becomes what? CH2, and then finally you have what? CH3. So the product of that reaction is CH3, then you have OH, CH2, and then CH3. So what will be the name of this compound? Now, we love to number it from here. This is number 1, this is what? Number 2, because you number from the side that gets to the OH first as the presiding functional group here. So this is number 3, and this is what? Number 4. So what will be the name? The name of this compound, we first of all, we name the substituents at this position, which is 2. So you call it 2-methyl, okay? 2-methyl, and then you call it what? 2-methyl-2, how many carbons are there? 4. 2-methyl-2-butanol. To tell you that at position number 2, there is the OH group, or you can name it as 2-methyl. Okay, whichever way that the options are, 2-methyl-butan-2-ol. 2-methyl-butan-2-ol. So that's the name of the compound. Okay. So the correct answer to this question is option B, which is 2-methyl-2-butanol. 2-methyl-2-butanol. Now let's look at the next question. The next question says the reactivity of the alcohol are in the order. Now the reactivity is in the order. The methyl alcohol is greater than primary, greater than secondary, and greater than tertiary. Okay. Now which is a methyl alcohol? Methyl alcohol is CH3OH. So this is greater than the primary. Primary alcohol is RoCH2OH, greater than the secondary. Secondary is Ro2CHOH, greater than the tertiary. Tertiary is Ro3COH. Now these are the various alcohols. The reactivity does what? It decreases down the group. Okay, it decreases. Now if it is decreasing, you use greater than. So this is greater than this, and this is greater than this, and this is greater than this. So we can say that methyl alcohol, which is CH3, is greater than the primary, which is this, greater than the secondary, which is this, and greater than the what? The tertiary, which is option C. Now this is due to steric hindrance. The tertiary alcohol is more crowded, so reacting to get to this OH group is very, very difficult compared to the other ones. Are we getting it? So the reactivity of the alcohol follows the order: methyl alcohol greater than primary, greater than secondary, and then greater than what? The tertiary alcohol. Let's look at another question. Now the IUPAC name of the following is, now for you to be able to solve this question, you must bring it out in the line, or let's bring it out in the full structural way. So this becomes CH3. Now this CH3-2 here means that you have two CH3 group attached to this carbon here. Now the carbon here is what? This carbon, which is this carbon. This carbon has CH3 group, and it has another word, CH3, on top. That is the meaning of this 2 here, that it has two CH3. Then you have what? Double bond. Then you have what? C, and this is H. Then you have C, 2H. Then you have C. Now this one means what? OH. And then you have 1H here. Then it continues to give us C. Then you have CH3 finally here. Now this is the structure in this way. Okay, let me write it well. There's a carbon here, and then there's this group here, and then there is CH3 here. How many carbons are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many are here? That is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and there was 6. So what will be the name of this compound? Now you number from the side, I will get to the OH group first, because the OH group has more priority as compared to every other group. So this is number 1, this is 2, this 3, this 4, this is 5, and this is what, 6. We consider this as our longest continuous chain. So the name of this compound will become 5-methyl, or probably the structure is not complete. The structure is not complete. Let me look at it again. These are many, 1, and then this is 2, 3, 4, 5, then 5, 6. The structure is not complete, okay? Supposed to be another CH2 group here. Let's improvise it. This is supposed to be another CH2 group here. This is supposed to be CH2, and this is CH3. Okay, so we have here as CH2, CH3. If you count this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7. This is supposed to be the complete structure given. So our number, we take precedence from that area. So we should now become, this will be number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, and number 6, and finally number 7. So the name of this compound will be what? At position number 6, we have our first substituent, which is what? 6. Then the substituent is what? Methyl. 6-methyl. And then we have the alkene group at position number 5. First of all, we have to name the alkene group. The alkene group is at position number 5. So we say 5. Now, the longest continuous chain is what? 7 carbon. 7 carbon is what? Heptene. So we have hept. So this becomes heptene. What? Now, the O group is at what position? Definitely, this something is wrong with this structure. Okay? Let's leave it first and answer to other question. Something is definitely wrong with the structure. Maybe I will check it and then correct that. Now, the conversion of two moles of this in the presence of an acid catalyst such as H2SO4 will give what? Two moles of what? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what is this? This is butanol, two moles of butanol, which is CH3, CH2, 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 and what? OH plus CH3, CH2, 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 and what? OH. This is one butanol and this is another butanol. When they combine, water is given off and it's called the condensation reaction. Now, this is what is called the Williamson ether synthesis, for synthesis of what? Ether. So we may need to rewrite the alcohol in such a way that the OH group can easily react. So this becomes CH2, 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 and what? CH3. So we have two butanol. Are we getting this one butanol and this another? Now, condensation reaction is when two molecules add together to form a larger molecule with the elimination of a small molecule. Now, in this case, the molecule that will be eliminated is H2O, which is water. Now, here is water coming from. We may decide to take OH from here and then take hydrogen from here. When these two combine, they give you what? Water, which is given off. So what will be the left as the product? You are left with CH2, and then you have CHO. So this gives us CH2, and finally CH3. Now, what is this? There's a butyl group here. So you call it what? Butyl ether. So it will give a dibutyl ether as the correct answer. Dibutyl ether. Let's look at the next question. Next question says, which of these methods cannot be used to prepare primary alcohol? Which of these methods cannot be used to prepare primary alcohol? A. Sodium borohydride reduction. B. Lithium aluminium hydride reduction. C. Reduction of aldehyde. And D. Reduction of esters. Now, primary alcohols cannot be prepared by the reduction of esters. Okay, cannot be prepared by the reduction of esters. Sorry. Now, esters can be reduced to form primary alcohol. Almost everything here can be reduced to form or can be used to prepare primary alcohol. So I believe this entire thing is correct, and hence there is no one that is actually not a method that cannot be used. All methods here can be used to form primary alcohol. Now let's look at the next question. Next question says, the boiling point of alcohols of the same molecular formula can decrease with the boiling point can decrease. Now, boiling point decreases with what? Increase in branching. Boiling point decreases with increase in branching. The more branched alkane, for instance, let's say you have two compounds like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then what? 5. They have the same molecular weight, the same molecular formula. But this one has a lower boiling point as compared to this one have a higher boiling point. Now, reason being that straight chain isomers have what, or straight chain compounds have a higher boiling point than their branching isomers. Okay, so that's the answer to that question. Now, the solubility of alcohol increases with lower molecular weight. The solubility increases with lower molecular weight. Compounds that are lower have higher solubility than the ones that are higher, or that the ones that have higher molecular weight. So that's the answer to that question. Now the next question says, the reduction of ketones with metal catalysts. Now when ketones are reduced with metal catalysts such as the palladium or carbon, the presence of hydrogen, now what will be formed? This ketone we form a secondary alcohol. Why? Because what we change is this one. This double bond here will change to OH. So you'll be forming something like this, CH3, then COH, and what? CH3. Okay? So this will form a secondary alcohol. And that is the correct answer to that question. The next question. Tertiary alcohols can be prepared from Grignard reagent by reaction with... Now, tertiary alcohols can be prepared from Grignard reagent by reaction with what? Ketones. When ketones react with Grignard reagent, the product is usually what? Tertiary alcohol. Now, let's assume this is a ketone and this is a Grignard reagent. According to what I just taught you, now what will happen? This will break, this will attach here, and this comes up here to form the OH group. This is not the procedure, but however, let's follow it like this. CH3, told you that this will change to what? OH. This attaches here, CH3, and this attaches here, what? CH3. What is this? This is a tertiary alcohol. So tertiary alcohols are formed from the reaction of ketones with what? Grignard reagent. I believe everyone knows why this is tertiary, because it has CH3, which alkyl group at 3 position about this carbon atom. So the correct answer is ketones. Okay, now the next question. The reduction of aldehydes or keto with lithium aluminium hydride requires diethyl ether or tetrahydrofuran, because 1. Lithium aluminium hydride is not a potent hydride donor. That is not true. Lithium aluminium hydride is very weak reducing agent. That is not true. The reason is because lithium aluminium hydride reacts violently with water or what? Alcohol. Hence, ether or THF, which is tetrahydrofuran. Tetrahydrofuran is something like this, okay? Tetrahydrofuran is what? Use. So it is either use ether, which are the general formula ROOR, or what? Tetrahydrofuran. Diethyl ether is CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3. You have the choice of using either of these. So this is the correct answer to the with the question. It reacts violently with water, alcohol, hence ether or tetrahydrofuran is used. Okay, now the next question. The acid catalyzed hydration of this will give, what product will this give? Now when you hydrolyze this, what product will it form? Now this is CH2, okay, plus hydration means addition of water. Now this will be in accordance with the Markovnikov rule. If this split will give us H and OH. Now the Markovnikov rule states that the hydrogen will go to the carbon with the highest number of hydrogen and the OH will go to the carbon with the fewest number of hydrogen. Now if I want to bring this out in the hydrogen format, you agree with me that there is a carbon here, right? Now this carbon, if we join them together to form what is there, you have something like this. There a double bond here. Now the valency of carbon is incomplete here. This is 1, this 2, this 3, and this 4. The next step now is, at what position will the hydrogen go to and at what position will the OH go to? Now Markovnikov rule says that the hydrogen will go to the carbon with the highest number of hydrogen. In this case, this is the carbon with the highest number, and then the OH will go to the carbon with the fewest number of hydrogen. In this case, this is the carbon with the fewest number of hydrogen, and then the product will be something like this. You have this group here. Now when this comes here, what will it form? You form the OH group, okay? So this will give us, let's say, OH. This OH attaches here, gives us OH. This CH2, this one will break. When this breaks and this hydrogen attaches, what will be formed here? This will form what? CH3. So the product of the reaction is CH3 and what? OH with this cycloring. And this makes option B the correct answer using the Markovnikov rule, okay? And that is the correct answer to that question. Now the next question says, the main product of the reaction between methyl or ethyl magnesium chloride and acetone is, now you have this, which is CH3 and then C double bond O and CH3. If you react this with CH3, CH2, MgCl. Now, if this is a theoretical exam that does not require you to write the reaction mechanism. Now, I told you that what you do is divide this here at this position. Then this one has negative. Attach this negative to this carbon here. This one goes up. This seeks a proton to form something like this, CH3. Then C here becomes what? OH. Okay, then this one attaches here to form what? CH2, CH3, and then finally we have what? CH3 here. So this will be the product of the reaction. Now if you look at everything that is given to you here, you discover that they are the same thing. This group here is CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, then CH3, 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 and OH. Now everything here follows the same pattern, just that they have different water arrangements, okay? Hence the correct answer is all of the above. The differences is that they have the same water arrangements, okay? Different arrangement rather. So the correct answer is all of the above. Everything here is the same. If you look at option D, this CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, still the same thing. Then you have CH3, which is CH3, then CH3, CH3, and then finally OH, which is OH then. So the correct answer is option D, which is all of the above. Now the next question, the reaction between hexyl magnesium bromide and ethanol formed between hexyl magnesium bromide and ethanol. This is supposed to be ethanol, not ethanol. Hexyl magnesium bromide and ethanol will form. Hexyl magnesium bromide is what? What is the formula for hexyl magnesium bromide? It's CH3. Then we have CH2, 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 CH2. This is how many carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we have MgBr plus ethanol. Ethanol is CH3, C double bond O, and what? H. When this duo reacts, what will be the product? I told you, using the same approach, this one will come and attach here. And when it attached here, what will be the product? So what will be the product? The product will be such a way that this one will attach here. Here it changes to OH. So this becomes CH3. C here becomes what? OH. Now if you want to make this easier, you can decide to put this hydrogen down here and then attach this group to this other side. So this becomes CH2. Okay, then CH2. How many carbons are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is 6. We've written 3. We have CH2, and what? CH3. Now what is this compound? These are many carbons. The longest continuous chain is, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and what? 8. So the name of this compound is what? 2. At what position is the OH? Position number 2. So we call it 2-octanol. 2-octanol. Because it has 8 carbons on the longest continuous chain and it's an alcohol. So that is the name of that compound. Let's look at the next question. Now, what would be the IUPAC name of this compound? Now, I love to look at it from this way. What is the longest continuous chain? This is the longest continuous chain. Forget about this group. This group here, they are cyclic ring, okay? They are cyclic ring. So there are two of them, which we can decide to call this CH, this CH, and what? CH3. Now, this is OH here. This group here has a benzene ring or a phenyl ring, which is 1, 2, and 3. This other one here is also phenyl ring. Okay, that is the meaning of that C6H5. C6H5 means what? A phenyl ring. So we have something like this here. So we have two phenyl ring attached to this carbon. Now, if you number from this side, this carbon will be 1, 2, and what? 3. Are we getting it? Now, the OH is at position number 2. If you also number from this side, this is 1, 2, 3, because this other phenyl ring are considered as what? Substituent. Okay, so this will be number 2. Now, what will be the name of this compound? To be what? 1,1-diphenyl propan-2-ol, or you can call it 1,1-diphenyl-2-propanol, and that is the name of that compound. Let's look at the next. Now you have the following question. The question says that the reduction of ethyl benzoate with lithium aluminium, this ethyl benzoate with lithium aluminium hydride or diethyl ether and water will yield. Now the product that it will yield is, it will yield a product in such a way that when you divide this into two, what will it give? This will give C6H5 and CO. Now if you reduce this, this will turn to an alcohol, and this gives us OH and what? H. And what is this? This benzyl alcohol. Okay, this benzyl alcohol. Now how about this other side? This one will also form an alcohol. So when esters are reduced, it forms two alcohol. In most cases, they are usually primary alcohol. Okay, to form two primary alcohol. So this case, this will break. So the general formulas for the esters are what? ROC double bond O and what? OR. So when this breaks, this will form ROCH2OH plus what? RO prime OH. So in this case, this will form benzyl alcohol and ethanol. Okay, and that makes this the correct answer: benzyl alcohol and ethanol. Next question: the reaction of tertiary butyl alcohol. Tertiary butyl alcohol is 2-methylpropanol, 2-methylprop-2-ol. Now let's write propanol. This propanol, right? Yes. So how do we put butyl in propanol? What do? First of all, we write OH here at carbon number 2. Now the butyl group is at, so at what? At carbon number 2. So we have CH3 here. Now this is 2-methyl propanol. Somebody may be surprised. Why did I write H3C? It's still the same thing as CH3, in case you don't know. Okay? Now, how do we number this? This becomes 1, this is 2, and this is what? 3. Okay? So this is 2-methyl propanol. When it reacts with hydrogen chloride, what is involved? Now, first of all, the CO bond is cleaved. That is true. The substitution of OH by Cl, that is true. It is nucleophilic substitution reaction, that is true. And therefore, the correct answer is what? All of the above. Why? Because for this reaction to occur, this bond here has to cleave to form a positive carbon cation. So this will be positively charged CH3 and what? CH3. When the CO bond split, it forms a carbocation. That is the cleavage of CO. Cleavage means what? To break down. Cleavage means to break down. Okay? In case you don't know, cleavage means break down. Now, when it is broken down, OH is substituted by what? Cl. So the product of this is supposed to give us CH3, C, then Cl, CH3, and then what? CH3. Now, if I take you back to your year one, first semester, you agree with me? Year one, second semester, organic chemistry, we are taught year two, first semester, we are taught SN1 reaction, and we are taught that tertiary carbocations or tertiary carbon center favors what? SN1. So this reaction will proceed to join what? Via SN1 reaction, which is substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. So all of the above are actually correct about this, okay? Now let's continue. The next question says, the order of reactivity of the halide with alcohols are the order of reactivity. Now, the order of reactivity, it follows that the one that is more acidic reacts more. Okay? Now, hydrogen iodide is more acidic than hydrogen chloride or bromine, which is more acidic than hydrogen chloride. And this is more acidic than what? Hydrogen fluoride. Okay? Sorry, not order of acidity. Now, the one that is more reactive is the one in which the HI bond can easily what? Break. Are we getting the one that the bond can easily break? And that one follows HI is greater than HBr, is greater than HCl, greater than what? HF. Okay, this is more reactive. Why? Because fluorine is more electronegative. Now, since it's more electronegative, what will happen? It tends to what? To hold this one closer to himself more. So to cleave this bond is very difficult. Okay, to cleave this bond is very, very difficult. Are we getting it? Now, this bond is more easier to cleave, and since it's more easier to cleave, the reactivity increases or decreases like this. So this decreasing order of reactivity. Okay, decreasing order of reactivity. So we can say that this is more reactive than this, which is more reactive than this, which is more reactive than this. Okay, so that is the order of reactivity, and that makes option D the correct answer to that question. Now let's continue. The next question says, which of these cannot be used for the conversion of alcohols to alkyl chloride? Which of these cannot be used for the conversion of alcohol to alkyl chloride by thionyl chloride? Which of these? Now you have pyridine. Pyridine is used. Potassium carbonate. We have lithium aluminium. Let me jump this one. When propanol reacts with methyl magnesium bromide followed by hydrolysis, the product is when propanol reacts with methyl magnesium bromide. Now, what is methyl magnesium bromide? Methyl magnesium bromide is what? Is CH3. Then we have what? Mg, and then Br. This methyl magnesium bromide. Okay, now when methyl magnesium bromide reacts with propanol is what? Is I believe propanol is CH, okay, 3, then CH2, and then C double bond O and H. This is propanol. Now, when the both of them react, what will be the product of the reaction? The product will be in such a way that this methyl group, according to what I taught you, we attach here, and then this changes to alcohol. So what will be the product? It will give us CH3, CH2, C, and then here we turn to alcohol, OH. This group we attach here can attach to this position, which is CH3, and then this hydrogen comes down since they are on the same word, carbon. Okay, so that is the product of this reaction, and this reaction is what? This is 1, 2, 3, 4. The name of this product is what? 2-butanol. So when it reacts, 2-butanol is formed. Now this is not the real mechanism, okay? This is just like a shortcut to ascertaining your answer. So the correct answer is 2-butanol, okay? And that is the answer to that question. Now the next, a molecule can hydrogen bond with its fellow molecule because, now what is hydrogen bonding? Hydrogen bonding is a bond that is formed when hydrogen is bonded to a more electronegative atom, such as oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine, sulfur. All these ones, they can form what? Hydrogen bond. So if you have an OH group, a more electronegative atom, hydrogen bond, are we getting it? HF, a more electronegative atom, what? Hydrogen bonding. So hydrogen bond, now the alcohol, they have what? The OH group. Abi now, yeah, the alcohols, they have the OH group, and since the alcohols have the OH group, oxygen is bonded to hydrogen. Now between oxygen and hydrogen, which is more electronegative? Of course, you know that oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen. Oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen, and because oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen, what will happen? A hydrogen bond can what? Can take place. Okay, so hydrogen bond is a kind of bond whereby a compound, or let's say a more electronegative atom, is attached to hydrogen, and the correct answer is hydrogen is bonded to a highly electronegative element, oxygen. That is why it can undergo what? Hydrogen bond. That is correct answer. Now, which of these alcohol can be prepared by the reaction of Grignard reagent and aldehyde? Which of these alcohols can be prepared by the reaction of Grignard reagent and aldehyde? Now listen, when Grignard reagent react with formaldehyde is something like this, HC double bond OH. When Grignard reagent react with this, primary alcohols are formed. Primary alcohols are also known as 1-degree alcohol. Now when it react with higher aldehyde, okay, when it reacts with higher aldehyde, what is formed? Secondary alcohols are formed. Secondary alcohol. So this is other aldehyde and then secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohol also calls 2-degree alcohol. Now, if it reacts with ketone, I guess you know what it will form. Now, let's guess together. When it reacts with ketone, what do you think it will form? If it reacts with ketone, it's going to form tertiary, okay? These are the ketones. So this will form tertiary alcohol, 3-degree alcohol. So you say, which of these alcohols can be prepared by reaction of Grignard reagents and aldehyde? Now, all of them will be formed if you react aldehyde, which is formaldehyde will form primary alcohol. Normal other aldehyde, like from carbon 2, ethanol, propanol, like that. The first carbon is 1, which is formaldehyde, also called methanol. These two, they are aldehyde. So when methanol react with Grignard reagent, what is formed? Primary alcohol. When is other aldehyde apart from methanol, what will it form? Secondary alcohol. When it is ketone, it will form what? Tertiary alcohol. So the alcohols that will not be formed when Grignard reagent react with aldehyde should be what? Tertiary alcohol. And which of these alcohol? This is secondary. Now this is primary. I believe everyone knows how to identify secondary, if it's tertiary or if it's primary. Now this is primary, but this is what? Is tertiary. Let's bring this out. This is what? C, and this is what? OH, and this is, there's a CH3 group here, there's another CH3 group here, and there's a final CH3 group here. So we have three alkyl group. Now we say when three alkyl group are attached to the carbon bearing the OH, what kind of alcohol is that? We say it's a tertiary alcohol. So this one will not be formed by the reaction of Grignard reagent with aldehyde, because this will only be formed by the reaction of Grignard reagent with what? With ketones and not aldehyde. Okay, so that is the answer to that particular question. Now let's look at the next question quickly. The next one said, acid catalyzed condensation of 2-butanol and ethanoic acid yields acid catalyzed condensation. Now, condensation of butanol and ethanoic acid. Note that whenever alcohol and carboxylic acid react, they react via condensation reaction. Water is eliminated and the product is what? An ester. Why? Because this OH here, let's say this group here, OH from here, combined with the H from here, we are just saying, and this will form ROC. What is left? Double bond O. Is there oxygen here? There's oxygen here. Then the OH of what? Of alcohol. So what do we have here? RO prime. Okay? RO prime. What is this called? This is called an ester. Let's say this is RO prime. Okay? This is an ester. So whenever 2-butanol or whenever carboxylic acid condensed with alcohol, the product is usually what? Ester. Now this is alcohol. I believe an ester must be washing this by now. And this is what? The carboxylic acid. Okay, so when the carboxylic acid react with alcohol, the product is what? Ester. So let's bring out ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid is what? Is CH3, and there you have C double bond O, and this is what? OH. If this react with 2-butanol, we can write 2-butanol as OH, and then this is what? CH2, and then this is what? CH3. Now, this is not 2-butanol, this is butanol. Okay? This is butanol. It's supposed to be 2-butanol. 2-butanol means the OH group is at carbon number 2. So let's say this is CH3, and then this is C. Let's put the OH group here at carbon number 2. This is CH2, and this is what? CH3. This is 2-butanol. So when they condense, what product will be formed? Let's say the product is formed here. The product that will be formed is in such a way that you have this group here, OH, combined with the hydrogen from here. So what will be formed? Water will be given off H2O. So this will give us CH3, then C double bond O, and then O. What are we left with here? We have the carbon bearing this, okay? And then this carbon is attached to what? This carbon is attached to CH3, and then attached to CH2, and then attached to, let's say, another CH3 group here, and then CH. Okay, no. Let's rewrite this again. Now, when this condenses, what will it form? It form this carbon bonded here. Now, when this carbon bond, we have this CH3 group here. So this CH3 group will be here, which is CH3. Then you have CH2, CH3. Now, is the valency of carbon complete? This is how many? 1, 2. The valency of carbon complete? No. So we have to add H here. That is to say, hydrogen is supposed to be here. Okay? And this will be the product of the reaction. And then you name this part first before naming this part. So this is what? Butyl. Okay? Butyl ethanoate. To form butyl ethanoate. Why? Because this group here is what? Supposed to be isobutyl. Isobutyl ethanoate, which is this group here. You name it first butyl, and then you name this group, which is what? The ethanoate group. So this is butyl ethanoate or isobutyl ethanoate, as the product of that reaction. Now that comes to the end of this lecture. Okay, that's the end of this lecture. So whenever an acid, carboxylic acid and an alcohol react, the product is usually what? Ester. In the presence of what? In the presence of an acid. That is why we said acid catalyzed. Okay, product is ester. Thank you for your time.